due to the graphic nature of today's show, parental guidance is strongly suggested.
No laughter has been altered in any way, shape, or form.
You people are idiots!
I just want to wax you.
I just want to talk.
I just want to ride a horse and shoot a gun. Is that too much to ask?
Hi, everybody, and welcome to NSS. This is the Reynolds Report. Since its launch 2 years ago, the YouTube Red setup has been bundled with Google Play Music for $10 a month. But that changes starting today, as it will become YouTube Premium, which is a $2 add-on above the new YouTube Music Premium subscription. It brings all of the access to original series and movies, plus access to YouTube that's ad-free with background play and downloads. Alec Baldwin is a dad. Again, the 30 Rock actor with his wife Hilaria took to Instagram to share the exciting news and to reveal the first photo of their baby boy. They shared, "He's here, he's perfect. Congratulations." Howard Stern recalls interviewing Donald Trump and how he rated women in a new teaser for David Letterman's Netflix talk show series, My Next Guest Needs No Introduction.
And I'd always call him Mr. Trump. He liked that. I'd say, "Mr. Trump, tell me, who are the great beauties? If I ask you some names, can you tell me who the great beauties are?" He goes, "First of all," straight face, "the great beauties, Howard, are not actresses. It's models and a lot of these girls who work in the, anyone who works in the entertainment industry, really, I've only seen sixes and sevens." So, you know, I'd say, "Well, Donald, I think Angelina Jolie is a great beauty. Seven." "Really, why?" "Well, come on." He goes, "You know who's a great beauty?" I go, "Who?" He goes, "My daughter, Ivanka. Now, she's a 10. And so we'd have these discussions.
Oh, my.
And of course, with the internet now, all these tapes are out there. Yeah. And they're still using them on a constant basis.
It's time for Things I Learned from Seinfeld.
"I am for open immigration, but that sign we have in the front of the Statue of Liberty, give us your tired, your poor, your huddled masses. Can't we just say, hey, the door's open, we'll take whoever you got?" Do we have to specify the wretched refuse? I mean, why don't we just say, give us the unhappy, the sad, the slow, the ugly, people that can't drive, if they have trouble merging, if they can't stay in their lane, if they don't signal, can't parallel park, if they're sneezing, if they're stuffed up, if they're clogs, if they have bad penmanship, don't return calls, if they have dandruff, food between their teeth, if they have bad credit, if they have no credit, Mr. Spot Shaving. In other words, any dysfunctional, defective slob that you can somehow cattle prod onto a wagon, send them over."
That's it for Things I've Learned from Seinfeld. Trump lawyer Michael Cohen threatened The Onion with a cease and desist letter over a satirical Trump article in 2013. You know, threatening The Onion with a cease and desist letter is about as effective as sending Trump a Hallmark "Don't be such an asshole" card. Oprah attended the royal wedding. It marked one of the few times that the Queen of England has ever been outranked. The official photos of the royal wedding have been released. I like the one of the Queen doing the electric slide. Robots can now learn tasks by watching and mimicking humans. My robot stands in the corner with his head down at parties. Toymaker Hasbro has trademarked the scent of Play-Doh. Yeah, it's the number one perfume of preschool teachers. The FDA has approved the first drug that can reduce the frequency of migraines. It works by blocking your brain's ability to process the daily news. The CEO of Bumblebee has been arrested and indicted on a tuna price-fixing scheme. If convicted, he's looking at 10 years in the can. There's an actual debate in the scientific community about whether octopuses are alien life forms. I have that same argument all the time about the Real Housewives. Two female shoppers in Montana who are both American citizens were detained by a Border Patrol agent because they were talking to each other in Spanish as they waited in the checkout line. You know what? They should have detained him because he was speaking stupid. Time for Nobody Gives a F***. The Pope announced that he's chosen 14 new cardinals, so be sure to check your email inbox. Hey, papal politics, nobody gives a f***. Levi's just released a smart jacket that lets you know when your Uber arrives. It's great for people who love to have all the latest gadgets, except apparently a phone. Hey, denim. Nobody gives a f***. And the CDC has announced that romaine lettuce is safe to eat again. So I guess that's what passes for good news these days. Lettuce is back. Hey, vegetarians. Nobody gives a f***. Thanks, everybody. We have a new episode of the Reynolds Report for you every weekday. Be sure to check out NSS Live, starring Frank D'Angelo and his panel of guests, Tuesdays and Thursdays on NSS.